Until 10 or 12 years ago, much of Eastern Europe was, for many of us, a mystery surrounded by an iron curtain. The changes that have occurred here since then have been pretty dramatic. But don't fall into the trap of thinking that it's just like home, yet. Doing business here is still problematic. Take communications, for instance. It's the lifeblood of business, but it doesn't always run smoothly in Eastern Europe.
The phone system is, to put it kindly, not in the best state of health. The waiting list to get a new phone installed in the Czech Republic is so long that it will take years to meet the demand. And if you're planning a business trip to Russia, rely on emails and faxes rather than the postal system, which is notoriously bad. Don't think that your Russian contacts have simply ignored your letters or chosen not to reply. They probably didn't get them in the first place.
Eastern Europe may have embraced capitalism, but doing business here has its own hazards for the unwary.
For example, most business people in Hungary feel that they've had more than their fair share of bureaucracy during the communist years. So now many of them have a natural aversion to issuing written memos, forms, and applications. But don't fall into the trap of thinking that means they're disorganized. They've just trimmed down the paperwork.
In the Czech Republic, they tend to be non-confrontational, especially in their business dealings, which is fine for them, but you could misinterpret their behavior and miss out on that big deal. Watch for the danger signs when negotiating with them. If your Czech contact lowers their eyes and goes silent on you, it's time to panic.
Of all Eastern European countries, Russia has probably undergone the most changes recently. The term New Russians has been used a lot in the West to describe those who have made their fortunes under Yeltsin and Putin. But never use that term if you're doing business in Russia. At home, many of those Russians who have made huge profits are viewed with jealousy and irritation. The phrase New Russian has become something of an insult. Use it to describe a business colleague or contact in Russia, and they'll not thank you. Although a lot has changed in Russia, some things haven't. Many aspects of behavior used in the old Romanov court are still in evidence today. Older Russians still consider it gallant to kiss a woman's hand on meeting. It's viewed as a sign of respect towards the recipient, not of a cavalier attitude to the weaker sex. They're very big on shaking hands too. Amongst male colleagues, a firm handshake on greeting and departing is customary, but only shake hands with female colleagues when you first meet them. And like the Japanese, the Russians love business cards, and the more letters you have after your name, the better. Be careful though when dealing with Russians, because often such formality doesn't extend to timekeeping. I know an American who was invited to a meal in a Russian home and arranged to meet his hostess at 7 o'clock at the local metro station. When the hostess arrived at 7:20, having been delayed by traffic, her guest had gone. That ended their acquaintance and any further business dealings. He thought that his hostess's lateness was inexcusable. She thought that his refusal to wait was the height of bad manners. In Russia, being 15 or 20 minutes late doesn't really equate to actually being late.
Rank is extremely important in the Russian business environment. Don't expect your next sales meeting to be held in the company canteen. It'll be held in the most senior person's office, and you'll be seated according to rank. If you're a junior member of staff, get used to lukewarm tea. That's because your superiors will be served refreshments well before you will.
Bonding with your Czech colleagues tends to be a far less formal affair. In fact, one which could lead to a severe hangover. Many business relationships there are formed in the pub after work, and if you're involved, don't expect to be able to duck out after the first round of drinks. That would be the ultimate insult to your new colleagues, who set great store on friendliness and establishing a cordial atmosphere. If you really don't want your head to suffer the next day, stay and order coffee instead. To the Czechs, it's your presence that's important, not your alcohol intake.
And before I go, a word about smoking. Let's put it this way, when it comes to cigarettes, most of Eastern Europe is a nicotine dream. In every Ukrainian restaurant, there are two sections. There's smoking and there's chain smoking. So a word of advice, don't ever expect to be asked if you mind someone else smoking. And if you are, never say yes.